Spasibo. You know, woke is someone out of a sleep. You realize you were asleep. As a parent, you learn real fast that kids don't sleep long enough for your taste. For children, the world is a brand new experience. Even simple shit is exciting to them. Kids, quote unquote, stay woke. They never take things for granted like adults and teenagers. There's a sense of wonder children retain that's sorely lacking among many adults, especially in this day and age of quote unquote information. The learned human is held to a high standard, but what gets lost is the price paid for being so knowledgeable. Countless hours of study, school, observation. Then there are debates with other knowledgeable people. You would think I'm talking about intellectuals, but I'm actually talking about the average person in these times. Because now, everyone knows everything. Those countless hours, that's people on their phones, researching. I wonder how many people go to libraries anymore. Most adults feel as though the smartphone makes you knowledgeable, and you've yet to understand that the more you think that you know, the less interesting and wondrous life becomes. Life turns mundane, predictable, a grind, a hustle, a task. Unlike children, eventually your adult energy begins to leave, slowly and surely. Sure, you have your days, but you wish you had the energy you once had, and you're only 25, or 30, or even 40, or 50. You're young. But you didn't realize the problem until it was too late. You see, the children stay woke. They know nothing but are eager to learn. Many adults still don't realize what the age of information is doing to your vitality, your drive, and thus your will. I referenced the future of the planet and the children in a couple of videos previously. Both are that damn important, especially the child we all have inside of our adult bodies. Adulthood, this old, massive experience, it's a shell to protect what's left of the child we are formed upon. Why do you think childhood is called our formative years? They are our foundation. And depending on the kind of childhood you've had, those formative years can make you a well-rounded person or a terrible one. Whether you want to ignore what the universe, life, is telling you, this is the era of therapy. In my day, only crazy people needed a psychologist. But over time, we've learned how silly that kind of thinking was. Because the truth is, the only thing that separates a sane person from a crazy one is that the crazy person wants to hurt himself or other people. The sane person, even if he talks to himself and shouts, if he isn't a danger to others or himself, well, the truth is, he ain't really crazy. The guy just may have Tourette's, can't help his outbursts. Morality, adhering to the social contract that keeps society largely civil, is what keeps things in some sort of order versus the Wild West. Sane versus crazy, order versus bedlam. Truth is, we're all a bit nuts, and I'll tell you why. This is a society with values that go from left to right and up and down. Every 10 years or even less, society changes. Some fight to change, but change happens regardless. Society is not completely stable. We all have to admit that we are a bit unstable because of the way society is. In times of instability, it's important that we have a foundation within us that we can turn to. For some, that's faith in a higher power. But if all else fails, the child inside of us can help us out. As long as that child grew up okay for the most part. I mean, where do you think you get your values and your teachings from? You were taught. A good psychologist or a therapist pretty much goes to the beginning, to reach that inner child to see how we became the adults we are, and to see where things may have gone right and wrong. This is an age of so many doubts and fears. The adults crying for mental health are everywhere, but really, the kid inside of them is scared shitless, and so many are so busy trying to be big, tough adults that many forget where they came from. Ignore the child inside, and the adult will suffer. 100%. God, man, I really hope you guys are getting what I'm saying, because it comes from a place of extreme concern. So many of you don't see your special, your worth, and every child should know their worth. How do you know that you are special? You should know because someone told you that you were. And if you never had that, just once is all you need, then the adult will always go searching for it. Just like we as adults search for so many things that we never had in our childhood. Attention, love, family, material possessions. No thing comes from nothing. There is always a reason. There are no accidents. There is no coincidence. Right now, their children playing somewhere because they aren't on their phones being locked into endless news cycles and advertisements. Notice how adults who take walks or go on vacations to other places seem to have a different kind of energy or vibe. You can sometimes tell by just looking at their pictures. That's a vital part of human experience, taking the time to do something different versus the same thing. For children, everything is new, and thus, life is never mundane. That mundane mentality is the mind of many adults, and it's also the signs of a potentially serious problem. This, currently, is a society with anxiety and depression. I'm a futurist. My mind has always been ahead. It's how I'm designed. But I'm gonna tell you, unless the Earth or the Sun changes humanity's course, apathy will be next up, and it'll make depression look like a party. Listen, seriously, if you're too much of an adult to learn from the children, then let the elders wake your ass up. Because an 80-year-old man would gladly take the vitality he had at age 25, 30, 40, and even 50. Wake up.